Hey guys, hi and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, then thanks for dropping in by my channel. Hi, I'm Polomi, and if you have already been there with me from my recent past, then no more introduction is basically needed. So today I'm going to show you how to achieve this particular eye makeup look, this tangerine eye makeup look, where I have played mostly with the color orange and some shades of brown. So yeah, this is going to be my today's look. I hope you will enjoy watching this entire tutorial. And if you want to know how I achieved this particular base makeup routine, then please head on to my Insta handle, which is @polomi_mimi. And from there, you can check out this entire base makeup routine. So yeah, now without any more further blabbering, let's dive into the video. So now, as you can already see, that I'm totally done with my base makeup and my eyes are totally prepped and primed. And to prep and prime my eyelids, I have used my all-time favorite combo, that is the PAC Spotlight Ready Concealer, which is basically this one. It is in the shade 0.5 Porcelain, which is this one. It is the lighted shade. And then I've used my K-Beauty HD Translucent Loose Powder in the shade White, and I've used it very slightly to set my eyelids. And now I'm going to take the same powder all over again, and I'm taking this powder and dipping my 3D HD Sigma blender. I am just putting it under my eyes to, you know, protect my under eyes from any kind of fallout if I get any. So now I'm going to go ahead and start with my eyeshadow palettes and my eyeshadow colors. And the very first palette that I'm going to choose right now is going to be my all-time favorite James Charles eyeshadow palette, which is basically this one. I'm taking this palette over here. I am going to dig into this beautiful color, like burnt orange color over here, which is basically this one. I'm taking this shade over here. I'm just going to put it onto my crease area. So taking that shadow onto my brush and dusting off the excess, I'm just going to place it onto my crease area and outline this area properly. So right now, when I'm done putting that burnt orange shade onto my crease, I'm just going to take another color and I'm just going to start blending it out. And to do that, the color that I'm going to choose right now is going to be this very orangish shade over here, which is basically this one. So first I took this one, and now I'm going to take and go and take this one. So I'm just going to take this one and start blending it out. So I'm like taking the color and blending it out. And while blending it out, I'm just using a very light motion. So while blending it out, let's do some chit chat. It's very cold in here. Like, I'm not habituated to this kind of a weather, but these days it's freaking cold in here and I'm like freezing out. And yeah, my hands are literally like cold as ice and frozen. So let me know whether it's cold out there also where you are watching it, what degree Celsius it is currently over there, because I want to know and I want to, you know, I want to get habituated with this. So yeah, I love winters. Winters are my favorite. I enjoy winters like anything, but winter is painful, trust me. It's painful, it's quite painful. So yeah, now when I'm done blending that orange shade, I'm just going to go towards my Orange Hue Glade palette from Colourpuff Cosmetics, and taking this palette over here, I am just going to take this beautiful dark brown color over here, which is basically this one, and taking this color over here called Ye Pill Me. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. So yeah, taking this color Ye Pill Me, which is a little bit brownish in shade. So yeah, I'm just going to take this one and I am going to put it onto my crease and darken it up and to give it that nice crisp border effect. So now at this point, when I'm done with that brown shade, I'm just going to take my eye makeup remover, which is basically this one, and this is by the brand L'Oreal. It's a L'Oreal Gentle Lip and Eye Makeup Remover for waterproof makeup, dermatologically tested and ophthalmologically tested. So I'm just going to take my Q-tip, and I have dipped it into the remover, and now I'm just going to clean up the area where I do not have any makeup. So yeah, I'm just going to take and clean up this particular area of my eyes. So now at this point, when I'm done cleaning my eye area, I'm just going to go ahead and cut my crease. And to cut my crease, I'm going to use my favorite and very usual concealer, which is the PAC Spotlight Ready Concealer, which is basically this one. It is in the shade 0.5, and today I'm going to use this one to cut my crease. So now at this point, when I'm done with my cut crease, I'll start decorating my cut crease. And the first color that I'm going to choose right now is going to be this beautiful color over here from my Morphe Exchange Shells palette all over again, which is going to be this color. I'm taking this color over here. I am just going to fill up my lid space. So I'm like taking that shade which I used the very last while doing my crease and my transition, the very beginning. So I will be going in that order only. So I am going to start with this one, and then I will go with the darker one, and then I will, at the end, I will be going with the brown. So that is going to be like the theme of today's eye look. And I am just taking the shade and placing it onto like this area of my eyes, and I'm just using it to blend outwards. So now at this point, I am going to take my burnt orange shade from my Morphe Extreme Shells palette, and which is basically this one. So yeah, I'm going to take this beautiful shade over here, and taking this shade over here, I am just going to put it onto my eyelids all over again and start blending that light orange shade downwards towards my lash line. So now at this point, when I'm done with that burnt orange shade also, so I'm going to go and grab my Orange Euclid palette all over again, and from this palette I am going to take my EME Pill color, which is basically this one, and I'm going to start putting it onto my lash line, and I'm just going to try and give it that nice brown smoky liner thingy. So now at this point, when I'm done with the entire look, even I'm done with putting on the brown winged liner sort of a thingy and smoking it out, I'm just going to take on some rhinestone and just going to put it onto this particular area of my eyes. So now at this point, when I'm done with those rhinestone, I'm just going to go ahead and from this particular palette, I'm just going to take on this particular pressed glitter over here, which is very beautiful in color. So I'm just going to take this pressed glitter, and I am just going to put it and spray, press it onto like this area of my eyelid. So now at this point, when I'm done with that pressed glitter, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this palette all over again, and from this palette I'm just going to take this shimmery shade over here which is called Tangerine Dream, and taking this shimmery shade, I'm just going to put it onto my brow bone and to give it that nice blingy uplifted brow bone effect. So now at this point, when I'm done with everything, I'm just going to go and put on some mascara and some falsies, and I'm going to complete the other eye, and I will be right back. So now I'm back after putting on my falsies, and for my falsies today I'm wearing my PAC M74 lashes, which are basically this one. So I hop them on, they are quite dramatic and quite wispy, and I have completed the other eye using the same technique. So yeah, this was my entire look. I hope you guys have enjoyed watching this entire tutorial. If you have enjoyed watching this entire tutorial, then do not forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel, because it will mean a lot to me. I'll see you guys next day with yet another more interesting topic. Till then, take care, keep it glam, and love you all as always.